Day two. Remember, this is where the concrete's gonna go. And we're looking at the inside. So this is the stuff that I did some years back. And if we look at it from the outside here, I wanted to leave this area right here open so that I could bring the lawnmower around and keep this area under control. You can see over here, I didn't give it that forethought. And so keeping that area under control over there is more of a challenge because it's kind of a manual effort. Looks like it's going to be an excellent day. Probably going to get a little rain, but at least it's not going to be too hot. Big pile of rock there for backfill in the where I'm putting those pavers. Some construction going on over here. Used to be a two-story building over there. Now they're building a title company. A three-story title company. I've got to mow. I wanted to stand there in the shadow to show me. Here's this thing, that thing being a trailer. All right, here's what I did. First of all, I welded on a little caster wheel right there, and I made this bar that goes across with the pin that goes in right through there, okay? So that bar can pivot back and forth like that, and I'm gonna drive the three-point hitch, just those two pieces right there, back it up underneath there, lift up the three-point hitch, you know, and lock those pieces down from the chair. That way I can hook it up and unhook it right from the tractor chair without having to get up. And then I can load this thing, and what I did was I just added in, you know, this top piece right here. They give it a little extra square footage, or a little extra area, rather. Volume would be the right word, and put in, extended it out a little bit so that when I, to be the, basically the width of the width of the bucket, that way I can sort of dump stuff in without having to spill too much.
More and more all the time. Hey, more! I'm ready to pay, yeah, my dues for loving you. Loving you too much, woman, you know I stand a cue.
Wave to Papa. Okay, gotta figure out how to set this tent up. Had a chance to relax a little bit. Just checking out these cool clouds. That one right there is a really interesting formation. Nice temperature. So we've got this area all to ourselves. Wanted to get an area up by this lake called Mirror Lake. But it was completely full. So we just found this little spot right here. You know, you're allowed to, it's all forestry land, so you are allowed to just pull into these little spots. And so it's actually nicer because, I mean, even though we don't have the water, we're not surrounded by people and noise. We are parked really close to this road out here, and I got the tent all set up, so that's the first time that tent has been set up for real camping other than the backyard. It's the first time I ever put this little screen on the outside, so you know it's a good sized tent. That was probably pretty hilarious watching me put it up. There was a fire pit right there, and I had to, when I first set it up, this screen thing was going to be sort of over the top of that fire pit, so no way, I had to move it back. And which everything would have gone a lot faster had I not done that, but glad I did. Oh, there's a little mushroom hunter. It's 8 o'clock.
It's 8 o'clock.
Making some tea. Two other of the crew are out mushroom hunting somewhere. What do you think, Alex? Okay. I think whatever that is, yes. That belonged to my dad. It runs off of the Coleman fuel. Just pump it up. Three burners. It's the first time it's been run in probably 20 years.
Is it possible they figured out a way to make a fire of peanuts? That's what I'm hearing. About 7 minutes, I'll see. It'll be great.